Another genocide of the Armenian intellectuals took place in Soviet Armenia during the years of 1935 to 1937. The Soviet government brutally murdered Yerisha Charents, Vahan Totovents, Axel Pakunts, and many others. Later on, Karapet Melikohanjian, Gurgen Mahari, Soromon Tarant, Khachik Hrachian, Mkrti Charmen, and others were exiled to the deep ends of the Soviet Union. At the meantime, World War II began, which claimed many lives of young Armenian intellectuals like Tatul Yurian and others. During the Soviet era, Armenia lived a relatively peaceful period, which created a good atmosphere for the growth and development of Armenian literature, specifically novelism. Great writers of this time were Axel Pakunts, Derenik Demirjan, the author of Vartanak novel, Hracia Kochar, Nairi Zaryan, and many others. In the post-World War II years, the genre of novels continued to flourish by the works of writers like Gurgen Mahari, Khachik Hrachian, Mkrti Charmen, who returned from exile. Another branch of the Armenian literature was the literature dedicated to the Armenian cause, which continues to develop until today. Following Rafi's tradition, the writer Hracia Kochar wrote the Otumnov Nahapet novel. Khachik Tashtens wrote Khodedan and The Cry of the Rajfars novel. Gurgen Mahari, The Burning Orchards novel. Mushel Galshoyan, Zorin Iron, and Vahan Terghazaryan, Royal Currency novel. The beginning of the Eastern Armenian poetry was marked by poets like Shiraz. His poetry ranges from soft lyricism to nationalistic motifs, which almost sound like cry for war. Silva Kaputikyan's lyrical poetry is in the same style of that of Shiraz. The most significant of her poems is Listen to My Advice, Son, which stresses the importance of Armenian education. Paruj Sevak is the unsurpassed figure in the Armenian poesy whose works are priceless. His innovative ideas became the foundation of new school in Armenian poetry. He was like a falling star who passed so quickly, but managed to leave a strong impression on the Armenian poetry. However, he passed away during the most productive period of his career. Currently, after the formation of the Third Republic of Armenia, despite the dire social-economical conditions and the fear of war, there is a great literary cultural movement. Many publications are being printed. The Armenians Writers Union is publishing NORC Literary Cultural Monthly Journal, Spring Young Writers Literary Journal, Literary Armenia Journal in Russian, Literary Paper, and many more children's, adolescents' papers and periodical publications. The most significant of these periodicals is the New Century Monthly Journal. At the beginning stages, the New Century was a monthly journal. However, in a very short time period, it was converted to a literary and cultural monthly journal published by the Armenians Writers Union. Since then, it has developed such that it encompasses the diaspora literature and culture as well. The New Century is also involved in publication of books. More than 150 books are in press, which are about epics of different nations like the Indian Mahabharatan, the Finnish Kalevalan, the German Nibelungs, ascetic Nordics epic, Irish Kulingi Swallowing of the Bull epic, as well as the Armenian classics and moderns. The New Century Journal has created an association of friends of the Armenian literature, which has chapters in almost all the countries of the world, like United States, Russia, Iran, Lebanon, Syria, Argentina, Italy, and others.